Okay, we'll do few more examples, and this time, continuing from last time, we saw how we found the radius of convergence, and we mentioned that the radius of convergence is finite. So right, again, what are the three possibilities? You either have the point C only, in which case it's easy, or you have the whole number line, which is also very easy. But when you have finite radius, you also need to check the endpoint separately, because the theorem does not tell you what happens there. So this will be an example of that. So we will use ratio test again as our investigative tool here. We are going to take the ratio of the n plus 1th term over the nth term. So this will be xn plus 1 over n plus 1, all of this over x3n over n, right? And this equals limit as n goes to infinity. So this xn will cancel with this, you'll have x at the top, and the n will come to the top too. You have nx over n plus 1, right? Now, when n goes to infinity, of course the ratio of n and n plus 1 goes to 1, so this just happens to be x, right? And ratio test, what are the criteria for convergence? If it's less than 1. So we want to be this to be less than 1, and that right away tells you that for sure things in here converge. Okay? But then the question is, what about the endpoints? What about x equal 1 and x equal negative 1? Okay? So let's erase this a little bit here. So I'll erase this part. When x equals 1, what does this series become? N equal 1 to infinity. Put 1 here, so you just get 1 plus half plus third plus fourth plus, right? And this is the harmonic series which diverges, right? On the other hand, when x equals negative 1, what do we get? So when x equals negative 1, what happens? The first one is negative, then it's positive, negative, positive, and so on and so forth. Negative this one, negative 1/5, right? This is the alternating harmonic series, and this one converges as we have seen before. You can use the alternating series test on it and to tell you that it converges. Okay, so finally, the interval of convergence, right? Which means the full set where it converges. Not just figuring out the radius, but the full set. Interval of convergence is the interval, minus 1 is included, positive 1 is not. So you have this is your interval of convergence. It includes minus 1 but not positive 1. Okay, notice again that this is a series centered at 0, and 0 is the center of this interval. So I would like to mention here that all four possibilities are possible. In other words, when you have a finite interval of convergence, you could have, so this is C, let's say, you could have just the open interval. You could have, you know, closed on the left side, open on the right side. You could have, let's say, closed on the right side and open interval on the left side. And finally, you could have closed on both sides, okay? Meaning both the endpoints are included. So these are the four possibilities of a finite interval. And in addition to that, we saw the other two possibilities are just the point C, right, and the whole number line, okay? So these are the six possibilities of domains of definition of a function that is defined as a power series. Okay, that should be be sufficient for now as an example. You should practice more. Now we're going to talk about in the next lecture how, since they're functions, whether we can think of their integrals and derivatives.